welcome to worship today on this Christ the King Sunday. I'm so glad you were able to join us. I have a number of announcements as we're getting started today. First of all, after worship, we will have a brief congregational meeting, so plan to stay for that, so that we can finalize our election for our church council. Right after that, join us in the fellowship hall. It is Thanksgiving Pie Exchange Day, so go ahead and come on downstairs. We have, I know of at least five that are down there, at least to start. I don't know how many there are now, but so we'll go ahead and everyone can take a slice of the pies in exchange for another slice somewhere else. So. Then you could kind of have a Franken pie, as it would be. So, also, today is the last day to RSVP for Owen Eller's birthday party. The information is in the back of the sanctuary. Special offerings this year, you can still give to adopt a family. There are special offerings in the back of the sanctuary for that. Our Thanksgiving offering this year is going to go to the Community and Family Services Food Pantry. And our Advent offerings are going to go to Grace Village. This upcoming Saturday, November 30th, we'll be Hanging of the Greens. We'll gather here at about 10 o'clock to decorate our church space. So if you're able to come to that, please plan to do so. We'll start at 10 o'clock and continue until we're done. My experience is that it usually isn't more than a couple of hours and often a little bit less. So come to as much of that as you might be able to. If you use the church year calendars that have the readings as well as what season the church year is, those are printed and available in the back of the church. If you need one of those, go ahead and pick one up. And I think the last thing is that Thanksgiving Eve worship is this Wednesday. It will be at 7 o'clock, so Thanksgiving Eve, Wednesday at 7 o'clock here at Zion. Grace Methodist is going to be joining us with that, and Pastor Jeannie will be co-leading that with me. Do we have any other questions as we're getting started? That was a lot of me talking, so. Michelle, can you, I'm sorry to put you on the spot, can you tell me when we're doing wrapping for Adopt a Family? The 8th. December 8th, after service? Before service? Before service. Before service on December 8th. If you are a person who likes to wrap presents, or if you like to watch other people wrap presents, please come to that. I tend to, unless it's something very square, I beg off that duty so that people have something that at least looks nice under the tree. But that is when we'll do our wrapping for Adopt a Family. Any other announcements as we're getting started? Okay, then let's just take some time as we prepare our hearts and minds for worship.
Thank you.
I invite you to stand as you are able. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who forgives all our sin, whose mercy endures forever. Amen. God of all mercy and consolation, come to the help of your people, turning us from our sin to live for you alone. Give us the power of your Holy Spirit, that we may confess our sin, receive your forgiveness, and grow into the fullness of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Let's confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Most merciful God, we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you and all the world we need, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and be us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name.
Amen.
God, who is rich in mercy, loved us even when we were dead in sin and made us alive together with Christ. By grace you have been saved. In the name of Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven. Almighty God, strengthen you with the power through the Holy Spirit, that Christ may live in your hearts through faith. Our gathering hymn is Onward Christian Soldiers, found in your green hymnal, hymn number 509, hymn 509.
Thank you.
bulletin. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Sovereign forever. Grant that all the people of the earth, now divided by the power of sin, may be united by the glorious and gentle rule of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Our first reading this morning is from Daniel chapter 7. As I watched, thrones were set in place, and an ancient one took his throne. His clothing was white as snow, and the hair of his head like pure wool. His throne was fiery flames, and his wheels were burning fire. A stream of fire issued and flowed out from his presence. 1,000,000 served him, and 10,000 times 10,000 stood attending him. The court sat in judgment, and the books were opened. As I watched in the night visions, I saw one like a human being coming with the clouds of heaven. And he came to the ancient one and was presented before him. To him was given dominion and glory and kingship, that all peoples, nations, and languages should serve him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion that shall not pass away, and his kingship is one that shall never be destroyed. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We'll read Psalm 93 responsibly. The Lord is king, robed in majesty. The Lord is robed in majesty and armed with strength. The Lord has made the world so sure that it cannot be moved.
Ever since the world began, your throne has been established. You are everlasting.
The waters have lifted up, O Lord. The waters have lifted up their voice. The waters have lifted up their pounding waves.
Mightier than the sound of many waters. Mightier than the breakers of the sea. Mightier is the Lord of the
ways are very sure, and holiness befits your house, O Lord, forever and forevermore. Second reading this morning from Revelation chapter 1. Grace to you and peace from him who is, and who was, and who is to come, and from the seven spirits who are before his throne, and from Jesus Christ, the faithful witness, the firstborn of the dead, and the ruler of the kings of the earth. To him who loves us and freed us from our sins by his blood, and made us a kingdom, priests serving his God and Father, to him be glory and dominion forever and ever. Amen. Look, he is coming with the clouds. Every eye will see him, even those who pierced him, and all the tribes of the earth will wail on account of him. So it is to be. Amen. I am the Alpha and the Omega, says the Lord God, who is, and who was, and who is to come, the Almighty. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Fighting to keep me from being handed over to the Jews. But as it is, my kingdom is not from here. Pilate asked him, "So you are a king?" Jesus answered, "You say that I am a king. For this I was born, and for this I came into the world, to testify to the truth. Everyone who belongs to the truth listens to my voice." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
be to you, Lord Christ. Please be seated. Dear beloved children of God, grace and peace to you from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. So wait a minute. Is Jesus a king or is he not a king? Today is a Sunday intended specifically to talk about Jesus as a king. It's called Christ the King Sunday, or sometimes the Reign of Christ. So many times in Scripture, Jesus tells his disciples that they are getting things wrong when it comes to what kind of leader he is. He's not the type of Messiah that would look like King David from long ago. He's not the type that will go to a palace or have a place high up on a mountain with patriarchs like Moses and Elijah. He explains to them how the Gentiles have rulers who are tyrants and lords over them, but how he is calling everyone to be a servant. So why, after all of that talk that Jesus does about him not being a king, are we here dedicating an entire day of worship to talking about Jesus as a king? Today, we use words and imageries that are tied to ideas of conquerors in what would be seen as glorious combat. We sing Onward Christian Soldiers and Battle Hymn of the Republic a little bit later. We sing Lift High the Cross as if the cross is some sort of a throne of honor instead of what it is, the first century equivalent of a lynching tree and a crucifixion, an act of terrorism. While we must recognize that Jesus taught that he is not the type of king we are used to, we have words from Jesus saying that he does have a kingdom, and he never actually denies the title King of the Jews. He says, "My kingdom is not of this world." In the books of Daniel and Revelation, we get a picture of a majestic throne room, and the pierced one. Remember how Jesus was pierced through his hands and his feet and his side at crucifixion? The pierced one is placed on that throne, this place of glory and honor and power. So is Jesus a king, or isn't he? It might be helpful to talk about how this day first entered into our church calendar. As a lot of you know, the church calendar that we use is of tradition more than anything else. Jesus probably wasn't born on December the 25th, and nobody in Jesus' day ever celebrated the season of Lent. Most of what we celebrate originated in the very early church, and it's become a part of our Christian life now. Christ the King Sunday, however, is a relatively new development. Christ the King was a celebration that only emerged in 1925. It was instituted by Pope Pius XI and was in response to the issues of his day, some of which we still face. In 1925, we were between two world wars, times when it was very clear how dangerous human rulers could be. The world was becoming more secular, and the vehemence and zealotry that people used to give to their faith was starting to go to ideologies, such as communism in Russia, or fascism in Italy and Spain, or the early stirrings of the Nazi Party in Germany. Pope Pius XI wanted to create a day where Christians would hear clearly and unequivocally that despite one's political or national allegiances, Christ is King. He wanted to fill the day with images of Christ coming to rule over all of humanity, rule over all rulers, all kings, all presidents, all prime ministers, all dictators, all chancellors. The intention was for all of the pomp and all of the propaganda that named people or nations as superior would be dismissed in the hearts of believers. Believers who would know that despite all human rulers, that Christ is King. Now, at the risk of being political from the pulpit, I think it's something that we need to remember in times like these. No matter what, no matter who wins any election in any part of the world, no matter what faction wins in countries that are torn by war, no matter who the winner is in any of these things, where nations are rising up against nations or people against peoples, Jesus is King. All the hymns we are singing today were those that were requested way back in the summer when we took hymn requests. And it might seem like we've chosen patriotic hymns today, but we haven't. In recent years, some of these hymns have been used to say things that they were not written to say. They have been used to say that the United States is somehow exceptional or specially blessed by God, or to promote the idea that one branch of Christianity should have greater authority in the United States than other faiths. All ideas that aren't in these songs at all. Onward Christian Soldiers is a hymn that I have a soft spot for. It was my grandma's favorite. And it's been used to say that the United States should be united as Christian instead of what it actually says, that all Christians should think of themselves as one nation, no matter our nationality. People miss the whole point of the song. It says, we are not divided, all one body we, one in hope, in doctrine, one in charity. Crowns and thrones may perish, kingdoms rise and wane, but the Church of Jesus constant will remain. Or later, we'll sing the Battle Hymn of the Republic. The only thing that's patriotic about that song is its name. No mention of country or of nation in the entire thing. We'll sing it as our sending hymn today, and it's not about any particular nation. It's about the reign of God. What all of this teaches is that yes, Jesus is a king. He is a different kind of king than any human king, or ruler, or president, or chancellor, or prime minister, or dictator. Jesus is king. We are called as Christians to be loyal first and foremost to our real King who sits enthroned in heaven. Today we learn that, without a doubt, Jesus is King. I think the other thing that we can learn comes not only from our knowledge of Jesus as King, but from the Pope who recognized the importance of the day like today, Christ the King Sunday. Jesus is King. And our human kings are not our Savior. It is right and good to be involved in the governing of nations and the states and the municipalities. We should always pray for those who are elected to lead and encourage and urge them to act for the betterment of the sick, the suffering, the poor, and the outcast, just like Jesus would do. Whether we agree with our elected officials and celebrate a political victory or feel disheartened in a political defeat, always remember, Jesus is King, and our human leaders are not our saviors. Our salvation is not in the hands of a human king, but in the hands of the true King. Our salvation is in the hands of the true King who has the ability to bring peace beyond understanding, who is the firstborn of the dead, who is the Alpha and the Omega, whose kingdom is not of this world. There is only one who is King and Savior, our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Our hymn of the day today can be found in your green hymnal, hymn number 377, Lift High the Cross, hymn number 337.
Thank you.
continue our worship with the words of the Nicene Creed found on page 6 and 7 of your bulletin. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Rooted in God's abundant love for the world, let us pray for our neighbors, the church, and all of creation. Revive our congregations, synods, and national church body to reflect the love, justice, and kinship of your kingdom. Raise up leaders to teach and serve your people. Be with all ministries in and around Hartford City. Today we pray especially for the people and ministries of First Presbyterian Church. Merciful God, nourish parched lands and bring relief to flooded places. Protect wildlife habitats and endangered species, that the chorus of creation's praise resounds with joy. Help us to protect and use your creation with care. Merciful God, be with those who are sick, suffering, or struggling in any way. Let all who call out to you be assured of your presence. Today we pray especially for Linda, Nancy, Carolyn, John, Ron, Carol, Mikey, Felicia, Rick, Brent, Abigail, Alan, Carla, and those we name silently or aloud. Merciful God, grant wisdom to the leaders who govern, legislate, and deliberate on our behalf. May justice and peace inspire those who lead and those who advise them. Merciful God, draw near to those who are detained, on trial, or incarcerated. Transform systems of retribution into systems of reconciliation and restoration. Empower activists who advocate for change. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
We offer our prayers to you, gracious God, trusting in your boundless love for all that you have made. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior. The peace of Christ be with you always. I invite you to share the peace with those around you.
Thank you. it's a little bit together. It's good.
To the ministries of the congregation, you can do so in the rear of the sanctuary. May God bless these gifts. We continue with our offering hymn on page 8. Service to others. We pray for the spirit of your word.
We pray for the spirit
of your word. To you be honor and praise and glory today and forever.
Amen.
Amen. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. forever and ever. People of God, receive this blessing. God Almighty, God most merciful, bless you, keep you, and give you peace. Amen. Our sending hymn is the Battle Hymn of the Republic, hymn number 332 in your green hymnal. Hymn number 332. Soon with our congregational meeting.
This meeting is called to order for the purpose of voting for council for 2025 as well as a cemetery trustee. So,